A Boston Marathon winner and a two-time Olympian, Desiree Linden can certainly run and run.
She's like a bunny. She can do this all day.
Let's go.
With the help of her USA teammate, Lolo Jones, we're going to discover what makes Desiree such a great marathon runner.
Hi, I'm Lolo Jones, and welcome to Anatomy of a Marathon Runner. Joining me in Las Vegas is U.S. marathon star Desiree Linden. Are you ready for this?
I'm ready.
Let's go.
Marathon running is the ultimate test of stamina, posture, and strength.
I love the marathon just because it's this mental challenge. Obviously, it's 26.2 miles where you're beating up your body and it's physical, but in your head, it's just that constant battle to keep pushing through the end.
Since finishing seventh in the women's marathon at the Olympic Games Rio 2016, Desiree has gone on to win the prestigious Boston Marathon. Now 36, this is how she measured up before our tests at a leading sports science facility in Las Vegas.
First up, we're going to take a look at Desiree's body composition with the DEXA scan.
So the DEXA scan is X-ray-based technology, and what it does is allows us to understand how much fat mass that the athlete possesses.
We can consider marathon running as like a gravity sport. Obviously, she has to carry her body weight around a course for 2.5 hours, and we need to make sure that she's an efficient body composition to support her performance.
Desiree has a body fat percentage of 19.6, which is higher than many other elite marathon runners. Her metabolism has slowed with age, but she's still incredibly efficient for her sport.
I think it gives females everywhere a sigh of relief because we stress so much about how much we weigh, our body fat. And if this girl is running 26.2 miles and has that body fat, it lets you know, hey, relax. Relax on the numbers. Sometimes they're not a true indicator of where you're at. When running for over 2 hours, you have to have good posture. This next test will examine her upper body strength.
The first test we're going to do is to look at the front portion of your core. You're going to be sitting at a 60 degree angle, and we're just going to hold that position for time. The second test we're going to do is going to be face down off the edge of a bench. And again, you're going to be in a horizontal position. We're going to hold that position for time.
Having good core strength is essential in ensuring marathon runners maximize their lung capacity and avoid wasting too much energy with excessive rotation.
All right, and we are going.
This is one of those deceiving tests that, like, it looks like it's not hard, but, like...
Much like a marathon, it's a long, slow, prolonged...
That makes sense. Felt really comfortable sitting at the 60-degree angle and just holding that, which makes a lot of sense.
When you were thinking about becoming a marathon athlete, mm-hmm. did you realize that sprinters get paid the same amount to run 12 seconds that you do for over 2 hours?
I tried that route, and then I just kept bumping up and up and up.
Yep. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
There we go.
All right.
Okay, next one.
Hands
up. Across your chest and just hold that position. Okay, we're going. Great stuff. Just keep this nice and horizontal. Perfect.
Now, what part of the marathon do you feel like you're in right now? Halfway?
She had a little bit of a dominance to the front in terms of her anterior core, but again, her performance standards, the duration of which she could hold some of these postures was truly outstanding and not surprising based on her size, her weight, and obviously how she has to hold herself during the race.
While some athletes would last just seconds, Desiree was able to hold the anterior and posterior positions for over 3 minutes, demonstrating incredible core strength endurance.
I know you have a lot of power and strength in those legs.
Do you think so?
I can only run 2 laps, so I'm just curious to test them out. You wanna do this?
I think that'll be fun.
Okay.
Okay, Des, so we're gonna do the counter movement jump, which is a vertical jump looking at lower leg power. If you look at the marathon, it's about over 50,000 individual steps in a marathon, right? So each one of those, you've gotta push into the ground, you've gotta produce force. Basically, you're gonna step on this force plate here. This is gonna measure how much force you put into the ground. We're gonna do a vertical jump for maximal height, and we'll see how your performance is.
All right.
Although marathon runners don't need to be as powerful and explosive as sprinters, they do need lower muscle strength to get through those miles.
Okay, step onto the plate, nice and still. Here we go, high as you can. 3, 2, 1, go. Up. Good, nice and still. Good job, Des.
She had a jump height of 32 centimeters, which is not truly outstanding. We wouldn't expect that when we compare it to something like a volleyball player, a basketball player, or any other strength power sport. She's very much an endurance-based athlete, works at lower intensities for long, sustained efforts.
I mean, Des, you're not gonna be a basketball player. Surprise.
I think I wasn't gonna be a basketball player, but I think I could probably do that test for about an hour straight.
Let's take a break from testing.
Let's.
Tell me. Oh, you're tired?
Yeah.
A marathon runner's tired?
That's right.
How did you get involved in your sport, and especially marathon? No one starts as a marathon runner, right?
Not at all. I really wanted to be a 1500 meter runner and then slowly worked my way up. But in college, it was like 10K is enough, coach. I'm not going any further than that.
Oh, so you were like determined.
That was it.
Yeah.
And here we are several years later, but you just keep bumping up. And
what
every
do you mean
time.
You just keep bumping up.
When you get too slow, you don't have this problem. But when we get too slow, bump up to the next event.
I've definitely gotten slower in my career, but I've stayed the same event.
So 800 meters in your future?
I like it. I like it. You might have changed my career back.
There you go.
What were the memories that, like, as a kid watching the Olympics?
Yeah, I watched gymnastics, a lot of gymnastics. So it was the floor routine in our family area, me and my sister, like doing the flips and stuff, just very poorly. But when I was in college, Dina Castor's bronze medal was just,
that was
a pretty inspiring moment.
And out for you.
Yeah, going into the stadium and she's got the tears and you're like, I want to do that one day. That's so cool.
So you ready for some more testing?
I think so.
Let's go.
What's next?
The 100 meter hurdle sprint test.
Cancel it all.
Now let's find out more about Desiree's endurance capacity.
The next test we performed was an anaerobic threshold test, which again is a really interesting test for a marathon runner.
Marathon runners use oxygen to fuel their efforts. This test measures the point at which the lungs can no longer inhale enough oxygen to manage the effort required. This is known as the anaerobic threshold or lactate breakpoint.
How many minutes is she going for?
She's
going
to go about 8 to 10 minutes. Now entering kind of the second minute of the first level, 8 miles per hour. It's going to go 9, 10, 11, and then 11 and it's an incline.
It's going to have an incline.
Yeah. 15 seconds, it's going to go a little bit faster, Des.
The treadmill test was, it's probably where I was going to thrive the most. It makes a lot of sense.
All right, speeding up.
She's showing no sign of pain at all because she's just, whatever, she just likes the pain.
All right, you can either jump to the side or I'm just gonna slow it down, yeah? You gonna jump? No, all right, here we go, it's gonna slow down pretty quick. There you go, good job, Des. Excellent work.
This is a really good test, again, for Desiree as a marathon runner and at the elite level. She produced a heart rate at her threshold of 171 beats per minute, which is the kind of area we would expect. But what was truly outstanding, she had a treadmill speed of 17 kilometers per hour with a 1% incline. So it shows us that Desiree has got the ability to go to those higher intensities before the onset of fatigue, which is critical for her sport.
17 kilometers per hour is the fastest pace at which Desiree can run before her body starts producing more carbon dioxide than oxygen. This shows she can work at high intensities without fatiguing.
It's been an absolute pleasure to monitor and assess and test a truly, truly world-class marathon runner. Obviously, she's not a basketball player or a volleyball player where she needs to run, jump high, and perform very explosive movements. For her, it's about sustained effort in the most efficient fashion possible, and she really demonstrated this today.
I'm Desiree Linden. Gotta run. Thanks so much for watching.